when you play for 1.4 billion people, when you go out there to play the Olympics, is a different feeling altogether. You know, I prepared for Atlanta very, very specifically. As soon as Barcelona had finished, I spent 4 years preparing for Atlanta. And I even took time off from the Pro Tour to play in tournaments which had altitude, which resembled the conditions that were there in Stone Mountain in Atlanta. I played in Belo Horizonte, I played in Bogota, I played in Quito, all the altitude places in South America on hard courts to prepare for that. When I got to Atlanta, I saw the draw that I'd drawn Pete Sampras in the first round. And all my contemporaries were like tapping me on the back and saying, bad luck, this is a tough draw and things. But I somehow felt there was a magic about Atlanta. There was something that was magical and mystical, which is very hard to put into words. But Pete Sampras pulled out, as history would tell, and Richie Rennieberg came in his place. I beat him in 3 sets. I beat Renzo Furlan in the quarterfinals. I beat Thomas Enquist in the pre-quarterfinals. I beat Nicolas Pereira, one of my best friends, in the second round. But then after losing to Agassi in the semis, where he had ruptured a few tendons in my wrist, I was in a hard cast for 24 hours. And the morning of the bronze medal match, when I came to play Fernando Melingeni, a Brazilian friend of mine, one of my dear friends on tour, I realized that it was more mind over matter that day. After I lost the first set and I was serving at 1-2, 30-40, in the second, something magical happened and I got into what we athletes call the zone, where you really don't remember what happened for that 45-minute period when I saved break point, won that game for 2-all, won the second set and served for the match at 5-4 in the third. I got into a zone where the crowd and the ambiance around and the pressure situation and all the nuances of what happened, I don't even remember the points because I was in such a trance. And that's why I talk about the mystical and magical experience when you play for 1.4 billion people, when you go out there to play Davis Cup, when you go out to play the Olympics, is a different feeling altogether.